Hi, podcast listeners. Today we've got a really exciting resource for you. We're going to talk about Google Art Project. We'll explain what this phenomenal online program is, how to navigate it, and most importantly, we'll talk about some really practical ways to implement it in your classroom. As usual, our suggestions will link back to Ausvals and the VCE. But if you're from outside Victoria, don't worry. We're sure our ideas can be adapted to any art curriculum. So, what is it? Google partnered with over 150 museums across 40 countries, and using a camera system similar to that of Google Street View, captured high-resolution images of artworks and the interior of galleries. The result? An ability for the online user to remotely walk through galleries and experience artworks in the context of a curated exhibition, rather than simply access isolated images in a traditional browsing sense. It also offers users the ability to zoom in to look at works in greater detail than possible with the naked eye. So let's take a look.
The Samuel model was created by Ruben Pintadura in the late 1980s to provide teachers with a way to self-reflect and refine their practices and pedagogy using instructional technology. It's a framework that outlines how technology can be integrated into the classroom. There are four levels of SAMR: substitution, augmentation, modification, and redefinition. Redefinition replaces tasks with things that could never have been imagined, takes us to new areas and new domains. The Google Art Project is a perfect example of this. The Google Art Project allows students to engage in learning tasks they could never do without technology. Teachers can introduce students to art galleries and spaces from around the world. Students can walk around the Louvre or the Musée d'Orsay from their classroom in, say, rural Victoria. They work with museums, archives, and cultural institutions from all around the world to bring their collections and artifacts online to the public to explore. All these experiences of the Google Art Project is exactly why the Google Art Project is redefinition, new tasks that were previously inconceivable.
Teachers who work in schools in rural areas or are otherwise unable to attend large exhibitions could use the Google Art Project in order to facilitate classes in a virtual space. For example, a teacher could organise an art scavenger hunt for the younger years, where you give clues to students about an artwork featured in the Google Art Project, and they have to find information about artworks, artists, and art movements by using the website. The teacher could also use the website to create a virtual excursion by splitting students into groups and asking them to look at various genres of painting and requesting observational notes or comparisons of some sort. The students are also able to save artworks and specific zoomed-in areas of artworks. This could be used to document their excursion and to perhaps answer questions. Students also have the option to compare two pieces of artwork side by side. This is a great way to see how artists have changed their style over time or how to look at trends across time.
In VC Art and Studio Art's Google Interactive website is a valuable resource that allows students to visit galleries expanding their access to art. This allows the theoretical and practical components of art to be combined. In the higher years of VC Art and Studio Arts, students are required to complete outcomes in this unit of 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. The outcomes in these units require the students to attain the knowledge of art history, analyse artworks, compare artworks, as well as attain the knowledge of how the professional context of an artist and galleries work together. The website supports students to gain this knowledge by providing visuals and information on how galleries employ curators, utilises conservation, hangs artworks and displays bodies of work. Google Art provides valuable access to education resources that can be incorporated into the senior art classroom context.
You could further enhance the educational experience of Google Art Project by tapping into the resources offered by individual institutions. Many of them, for example New York's Whitney Museum, publish downloadable teacher guides designed to be accessed before, during, and after your museum visit. These guides cover the exhibition's key themes and concepts and could be incorporated into both senior and junior art classrooms. So enjoy your Google Art Project experience and don't forget to share your ideas about and experiences of the tool in the comments section below. Until next time.